My name is Mark Pedersen. I'm a Missourian and a criminal. On the dictates of some in our state and federal government, I am an enemy of the state. By the fact that I have found profound relief from my illness, when pharmaceuticals only did more harm, I must live under the constant threat of arrest. I live in Kirkwood, but this has not always been my home. I was born and raised in Kirkland, Missouri. The Dorel lead smelting plant, its smokestack, and the constant noxious discharge were an ever-present reminder of the toxic chemicals that my friends, family, and of course myself were ingesting every hour of every day. It was there in Herculaneum while remodeling our home that I was exposed to very high levels of lead, cadmium, and arsenic. Soon after, I became very ill. After an exhaustive line of expensive medical tests at the hands of the best physicians and specialists St. Louis had to offer, my condition was labeled fibromyalgia with severe migraines, hardly a suitable description for the agony I suffered daily. Most weeks, I experienced 2 to 3 moderate to severe migraines a week. Each migraine was like a mini seizure, with a little more of my short and long-term memory disappearing with each episode. Pharmaceuticals did little to control the headaches. Consequently, my migraine specialist regularly took medications, often with horrific results. My stomach was constantly upset from the illness and the continually changing regimens of prescription drugs. The pain, weakness, and confusion made it impossible for me to work. I had to leave my certified welder and pipe fitter position with Ameren, QE, or electric utility, my computer consulting business, and close the much-needed food pantry my wife and I had founded and ran for many years. Later, we lost our cars, our home, and eventually our marriage. In 2001, my eldest daughter passed away from the illness that has affected my whole family, including my 2 surviving children, my now ex-wife, and just about everyone we knew there in our hometown of Herculaneum. My only reprieve came when I read an obscure story about a fibromyalgia sufferer benefiting from cannabis. I obtained some from a friend. After only 3 weeks, my migraines had reduced significantly. In the coming months, my migraines continued to reduce in intensity, the stomach and connective tissue pain eased, and my memory began to return. That was over 10 years ago. Now my headaches are virtually non-existent. My memory has improved dramatically, particularly my long-term memory. I can once again remember the birth of my 3 children, and childhood memories have returned. The symptoms of my fibromyalgia, as well as my migraines, are easily manageable as long as I have an adequate and continual supply of my essential holistic medicine. If only my medicine were legal in this state. As it stands right now, I can legally obtain the most toxic and habit-forming narcotics available, but the safest, most effective medication for me could land me in prison for a long time. Missouri's cannabis patients are forced to make a choice between a reasonably normal life with cannabis or having a career, a family, or even a home, for that matter. We're not afforded the luxury of more than one. According to the federal government, we're not even allowed that. The chronically ill want to be heard. We're weary from the senseless persecution that we have been forced to endure. That's why so many of us are stepping out of the shadows to express our inalienable right to choose the medication that we and our physicians know is best for us. Please support our Missouri Medical Cannabis Bill, House Bill 1830. The legislation would ease the suffering of Missouri's chronically ill by allowing us to safely and legally face our illnesses with a proven safe alternative. For many of us, there really is nothing else. Passage of this bill would also permit unfettered physician research, support, and guidance. If we're really concerned about Missouri's chronically and terminally ill, isn't that their and our quality of life a real issue?